everyone, and welcome to Truliving Africa, your one-stop hub for all things wellness. My name is Oyin Kotalabi, and I'm your host for today. Thank you for stopping by. Stay tuned for a fantastic session. So we just went through Valentine's month, where everybody was all about love, 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 love. And love is a great thing. I love love. But I wonder how many of us actually pay attention to ourselves and make time out to love on ourselves. That's what we're talking about today, loving ourselves. How often do we take time out to actually look in the mirror and say to ourselves, you're awesome, you're beautiful. All those good things that we say to other people, when do we actually make time out to say that to ourselves? Do we accept ourselves for all our good, our bad, and all our not so nice bits? Well, self-love is a very, very important part of our well-being. If we do not love ourselves, then how will other people love us? And another interesting thing about self-love is that it's a way of oscillating our energy. And we have energy on four different dimensions. We have spiritual energy, mental energy, emotional energy, and physical energy. And we always want to be replenishing all those three types of energy because we are always expending from them. And we know that we cannot give what we do not have. So if we keep expending physical energy but don't replenish, then we're going to get worn out. Same thing with mental, emotional, and spiritual. So today I'm going to be sharing with you the ways that I replenish myself, I oscillate my energy, and keep appreciating myself and loving myself. One of the main things that I do to replenish my energy is music. I love music, and so I listen to all kinds of music. Well, except reggae and rap, but any other kind of music works for me. I like music with soft tones. I also pay attention to the lyrics that I'm listening to, but depending on my mood, I always find a track that will get me there, that will help me to just relax, that will help me to process my thoughts. Sometimes I'll listen to classical, instrumental, whatever it is. And I encourage you to try that as well. What kind of music do you like? What are the lyrics that are riding on the music that you're listening to? Because remember, when you are in that very relaxed space, the music, the lyrics go into you and you are just into your subconscious and you end up singing along without necessarily paying attention to the lyrics of what it is that you're singing along to. And every time you're singing along, they're like affirmations. So you're affirming certain things to yourself. So pay attention to the music that you're listening to. What kind of vibration is it? Is it hardcore? Is it soft? What kind of mood are you trying to bring yourself into? So depending on that, choose your music based on that. Don't just go for the melody. Think about the lyrics as well. But music is definitely one of my top ways of relaxing and just reconnecting with myself, body, mind, and spirit. Another thing I love doing is reading. Reading is an amazing escape route for me. I can do it by myself, sit in a quiet place and just be translated into a different world altogether. And, you know, it helps me to improve my vocabulary, my creativity, my imagination, teaches me about things, about people, about places, concepts. You know, it's a great way to expand your mind. And it's also something that we are losing. The other day I was going through some of my pictures and I used to go for book readings. I realized that I don't go for those anymore, even though I still read. And it's something that I like to go back to doing, even attending book readings where the author will come and share the thoughts behind what it was that about their book. But reading is a great way of escape, is a great way of replenishing. There's a book that I'm currently reading right now, and it's called Redeeming Love. It's by Francine Rivers, and it's a fantastic book about love, about forgiveness, about redemption, and just very, very encouraging. I'm loving it right now. What book are you reading? Share with us. Another thing that I love to do to show appreciation for myself or to my body is I get a massage. A lot of people always think massage is for rich people or for people that don't have a lot to do. But living in this hectic Lagos or hectic country of ours, a massage is a necessity. One of the things that our bodies does is that it absorbs tension. So our muscles get tighter. Another thing that happens is that every day our minds are pulling in information from different areas or all around us. And so there's a lot of things that's been taken into our subconscious that we're not paying attention to. When you're getting massage, all the tension is being removed from your muscles. As that is happening, the whole ambience of the place is helping your mind to also declutter and your spirit to reconnect with the divine. And so it's a very, very important practice for us to try. Also, your lymphatic system is also getting a massage so that it can circulate and remove toxins from your body. So not only is it relaxing, it's also a way of detoxing as well. It's a very, very important thing. And it's something that is not as expensive as we imagine. You can also get massage therapists who will come to your home and create a nice ambience for you and give you a great massage. It's something that I think that we should all practice as often as we can. One of my favorite things to do is working out. I just love to exercise. I mean, sometimes if I haven't exercised for a while, it takes me a minute to get back into it. And I know that happens to everybody, so I can relate. However, when I exercise, I can feel myself reconnecting with myself. It's almost like I'm having an in-body experience. My body is coming back home to itself. And sometimes I want to exercise by myself. Sometimes I want to exercise in a group. Sometimes I want to do something like yoga or Pilates, which is low impact. Sometimes I want to do something like dance or, you know, go for a walk outside. Whatever it is that my mood is feeling like, I try to indulge it as much as possible. So I go with it. There's so many fitness clubs around, so many fitness studios, trainers doing amazing things, great classes, creative classes that you can join into, whatever it is that you're feeling. Sometimes it's group, sometimes it's you by yourself. Go for it. Sometimes it's morning, sometimes it's afternoon, sometimes it's evening. Go for it. However way that your body is feeling, it's just your body wanting to oscillate the energy around it, within it. So I encourage you to try that as well. One of the things that I also like to do is to go into a steam room or a sauna. Now, a sauna is a room that has dry heat, while a steam room has wet heat. And what the heat does is that it opens up your pores and helps your body to detox. As you know, sweating is a way of detoxing. So you'll sweat out all the toxins in your body and you come out of there completely relaxed. Your muscles are relaxed. Your mind has also gone through a detoxing process. At least that's what happens for me. Even mentally, I feel like I've had a detox. And then you come out of that hot room and you go and you have a cool shower to cool down and rinse off all the toxins from your body. It just feels very, very relaxing and refreshing. A lot of gyms and spas tend to have a sauna or a steam room. I encourage you to try that and incorporate it into your lifestyle. Another way I love to show appreciation and love to my body is by having spa moments at home. I mean, it's great to go out to the spa and be treated by somebody else, but sometimes it's actually really nice and economical to do it at home. And so when I want to do it at home, I would usually start out by exercising, so my pores are all nice and open, and then I'd cleanse my face And then I'd mix up, I like to mix up things by myself. Sometimes I'll use a face mask that I already have, or sometimes I'll make my own. So I'll mix up some honey with some oats. I might put in lemon in it. Whichever way it is I'm feeling, whatever it is I have in my fridge or in my bathroom cabinet, I'll put it on my face. It sits there for like 15 minutes. And then, you know, things like the oats will help to exfoliate the skin. If there's honey in there, it's a great moisturizer. The lemon as well is a great antioxidant for the skin as well. So sometimes I put in turmeric as well, which helps to brighten up the skin. So, you know, those little moments, and by the time you sit there, you're waiting for it to dry. I sometimes will clean my nails and prepare to give myself a little manicure and a pedicure. I love to change my nail polish. I love to do it myself. And so I would sit down there and clean my nail polish so that by the time I take off the face mask and take a shower, then my nails are all nice and clean. And then I can give myself a fresh coat of nail polish as well. You know, it's a nice lazy day that you do this. And in the whole process, your mind is decluttering. You're reconnecting with your body. You're doing something that you enjoy. I mean, this is what works for me. Home spa might not work for you, but, you know, it could be something like reading, or you could have a hobby that you enjoy. Either way, you're doing something by yourself. You're reconnecting with yourself, and you're oscillating that energy within you. So try a home spa, or try something that you enjoy doing by yourself. When I realize that everything that I put into my mouth is either feeding disease or health, clean eating became a part of my life. I became much more conscious of what it was that I was eating, when I'm eating, and how I'm eating it. And so I always try to find a balance. So clean eating is definitely a way of showing my body that I appreciate it. So I feed it with as much nutritious food as I can. I drink water, as more water than anything else. I pay attention to the processes of that my food has gone through. Those little things, it just helps to show my body that I really appreciate you. I want you to be in your top form as much as you can. And that's a way that I choose to show my body love. Another way of showing my body love is detoxing. I mean, detox is basically about clearing out the junk that is in our system. I mean, we declutter our wardrobes, we clean out our houses and our cupboards. Well, we should also clean out the junk in our trunk as well. We should clean out all our intestines and everything that has been backed up in there. So sometimes I'll go on a juice diet for like 3 days, drinking only juice and water. It is tough, I tell you. However, sometimes I do that. Sometimes I'll go on just a raw diet. So I'm only eating salads for three days. Sometimes it could be for a day. Sometimes I will just not eat meat. I love my meat. But meat is hard for your body to process. So sometimes I'll give my body a rest and not eat meat for a day or two. It's usually not two consecutive days. That's hard for me. But except I'm doing a juicing detox, then I'd leave out the meat for 2-3 consecutive days. But apart from that, I'll just take a day of rest from eating something like meat, and just basically allow my body to rest, allow the system to rest. Every time I do it, I always find that I have much more energy. I feel lighter. And a detox has gone through even with my mind, because I'm not as active going up and down as much as I do. So when you're detoxing, I encourage you to do it over a weekend or when you don't have a lot of activities, so that you can feel the full benefits of it at the end of the process. So there you have it. You have all my secrets. These are the things that I do to help myself just stay connected with myself, to tell my body that I love it. I tell myself that I love myself. I have a friend that says that my shakara is on another level. Well, my friend's dad used to say to us that if you don't love yourself, then nobody is going to love you. So we have to take time to love ourselves. We have to take time to love on ourselves. It's one thing to say, it's another thing to actually have habits and practices that actually show yourself that you love it. Your spirit will thank you, your mind will thank you, your emotions will thank you, and your body will definitely thank you. So I encourage you to start incorporating little practices every day, weekly, that just tell yourself, reaffirm to yourself that you are loved. So thank you for tuning in today. We look forward to having you again with us next week. Share the link with somebody, with your loved ones, with your family, and see you soon.